I know one of you are waiting for the curator talk. I'm not going to say more than a few words. Again, on behalf of the National Gallery of Modern Art and the Ministry of Culture, I welcome you all for this wonderful show. It's been a privilege for the National Gallery of Modern Art to be hosting quite a lot of exhibitions in the recent past. And during this year, this is the second one on photography. Coincidentally, this year happens to be the International Year of Light, and light and photography are inextricably linked with each other. Art again is playing with light, color, and shadow. I'm sure Sunil Janah has played his major role by using these three properties of light in his photography, about which Ram is going to be speaking about. So, once again, thank you all for coming to the inauguration of this program, and please do enjoy the show. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Kader. I request Ram to talk a few words about it. Ram, you're going to take a big share at the end of the show, but just to start with, and then Mr. Agarwal will have a word.
Well, first of all, I'd like to thank the NGMA Bombay, Firuza Godrej, Mr. Kenneth for hosting this exhibition, which I hope is a significant exhibition. But I would also like to specially thank Vijay Kumar Agarwal, without whose quiet and eccentric, in a way, initiative, this exhibition would never have happened. The work that you see here, the photographs, were bought by him in one lot a number of years ago. I had not really known Mr. Agarwal well. He was an acquaintance I had met through Bim and John Bissell many years ago, who were very close to us, to the family. And I would occasionally see him in Christie's and Sotheby's in New York when I lived there. So I knew he had an interest in art and was also collecting. But the very unusual thing about him, which has led to this show, is that he actually bought a body of photographs like this at a time when nobody was buying photographs and no art collector was either looking at photographs or collecting photographs. It happened to be a body of work by Sunil Janah, who was a hugely significant photographer. I'll talk a little bit about that upstairs in a few minutes. It was also, you know, serendipity, and I would also like to thank Nitin Bayana, who's the collector in Delhi, who actually clued me into Vijay's collection and told me that Vijay Agarwal has 300 eventually Janah prints, and I said that's just not possible. I didn't believe it because Janah never showed his work. I mean, he never gave his work, he never sold his work, and you know, he ended up, when he died in 2012, all his work is sitting in his house in Berkeley, where it is still sitting, the house is locked up. So I didn't believe him, I said it's not possible, and I made it very hard, but he insisted that I come across the Jamuna, and I did have to cross the Jamuna, to go and see. What I discovered was an amazing private archive collection with a private gallery. And that's another very unusual thing for a private collector to, you know, actually build a gallery like that, and then get someone like me to help him bring out a collection like this in public. So I think that's a very special thing, and I'm so glad that it's happened at an institution like the NGMA, because nothing could be more public than this. And thank you all for coming.
Since we started and finally it happened. And it's a privilege to be showing our works in NGM of Bombay. And as Ram was saying, he didn't believe that we had this Christian photograph. And finally, when he did come to my building, and as we were walking up the stairs, he saw two pictures, and that's my mother.
That one over there.
Yeah, those two pictures were hanging on the stairs. But that's my mother. He had never seen those. He had seen every picture of Sindhana except his mother, and then there was a picture of his grandmother dancing. So then finally got convinced, and we did a show in Delhi, and he also did a book for us, which is the, you can see outside. And regarding my collection, basically I used to travel as an international businessman, and after 1 hour meeting, what do? You go to museums, you go to the shops, you start and